And we're scribing the deck.
Curve on this other piece. And
you may be able to make out that I've already done that, but thought I'd show you anyhow. Well, I guess I could plug it in. I don't know. It's plugged in.
And here we're using the belt sander to smooth down to the scribed line.
Perfect.
Pre-coating the coaming parts and around the edges of the hatch itself. Putting in the wire stitches to hold the coaming pieces in place. Highly recommend wearing long sleeves, and some portions of this video have been edited to eliminate the bitching.
It shouldn't go anywhere. Shouldn't.
Want a rag?
Not yet. All I'm gonna do is go up there with it. Don't land it. A stool to stand on, stick my head under there. A light. A hat to keep the glue out of my hair.
You like a head torch?
And the bottom side of these outside edges. Okay? Okay.
Which part? All this edge?
All that edge.
Bottom edge, top edge?
Bottom.
This is the bottom.
That's the bottom. Bottom of the X. Forward. So on the inside or the outside, you think? If I quit standing on this board, I'd probably get it out of my way. Thinking epoxy.
Yeah, give me one of those rags because I got drips.
Okay, I was gonna say, look at the drawing there and see what side I'm supposed to tie these off from. That side or this side?
Looks like you're supposed to have one.
Huh?
What side you're supposed to have what on?
Tie the wires, twist the wires. Must be the inside.
Yeah. Well, inside on port side and outside on starboard side.
That's the port side.
Right.
So, the only ones I'm using on the port side are at the corners. Okay. Give me one of them. The whitest is the front, but we'll see. Wires there down here. Okay, that's a start. Let's do this one up here. There's your measuring tool. And the corner. Have them totally is there no more that's the corner. Okay. Come on. Go through there. Sitting in the glue racks. wrapped on all wire. You got another 30 seconds here, Rex. You're doing fine.
This is... I need a clamp on it.
You need to wipe the inside too. It may even take that. Hole in the glove. You probably got to back this up a turn or two to get them on. Looks pretty good. I'll get them. You just wipe. Keep wiping. We got plenty of places to wipe. Can scrape some down in there. It's rare on a boat when you have a 90 degree corner, you can actually use a clamp for a picture frame. It's rarer yet when I can make a 90 degree corner. That's good.
Well,
it's perfect. Okay. Get the bowl up here. Maybe I can use some. It's probably a waste of time. It's too far gone. Never mind. Another good wet rag. That's what I want. And yes, it's what? 92.5 degrees in here, so epoxy does kick off. Perfect. I don't need a damn one yet. By the time it sets up, it ain't gonna move anyhow, and then we can do the finish. It's just perfect. you may have noticed that you see a lot of people that'll mix up thickened epoxy and put it directly on the joints. We like to pre-coat with just straight epoxy any pieces that we're putting together. That way it has a better chance of soaking in to the wood a little further, and you don't end up with any joints that fail on you because they weren't wet enough. And that's our bit of wisdom for the day. Thickened epoxy. Nah, that's too much. Just one pump. Perfect. Okay. You calling it done?
Yep.
Can't think of anything we've forgotten.
Filling the void in there inside the cabin there. That stuff too hard to.
I need to do it when I can get in there. Easy. We'll deal with it tomorrow. Next day. Mm-hmm.
Back here.
No, not really. I did. Honest. And if you do this often enough, you'll get really good at it and never make any mistakes. Thank you. here at one end.
Which one are you going to get?
That one. We'll do. Drywall screws in to hold things down, sometimes they end up gluing themselves to the boat. Yeah, the project. So the only thing to do is heat them up and hopefully they'll come out without breaking. That's my problem, is I don't want to break them. Because then they tend to rust and cause other problems inside the hole. So we're trying to heat it up. Not very effectively, I might add. Come on. Hot after you get them out. So wear a glove. Of course, if we'd have waxed the threads on these before we stuck them in, we'd have probably not had this problem. But I never think of that until after the fact when I'm trying to get them out.